Hello everyone, my name is Atsunori Okamura from Sakurabashi Watanabe Hospital. Following the angio-based 3D wiring method, we will be explaining the IVAS-based 3D wiring method and be demonstrating it here at Terumo Medical Phoenix.
I'll explain the IVAS-based 3D wiring briefly. IVAS-based 3D wiring is possible when performed with a short tip pullback IVAS using the tip detection method. There are two situations where the IVAS guided wiring can be used in the anti-grade approach. One is to observe the entrance of CTO and the guide wire from the side branch like this. And the other one is to observe the tool lumen and the second guide wire from the subinterval space like this. IVAS-based 3D wiring can be used in both situations. There are two methods for IVAS guided wiring in the CTO region in Japan. One is the image delayed IVAS guided wiring. This is a way to check the location of the guide wire in the CTO region after several attempts of the guide wire advancement to the position that is presumed to be the true lumen on the angiographic images. Perform 3D wiring using the fusion of two images method. The other one is a real-time IVAS guided wiring. This is a way to perform the 3D wiring using a short tip pullback IVAS with a tip detection method. This slide shows how to construct 3D image during IVAS guided wiring. The first guide wire is advanced into a subintimal space, and the IVAS is advanced through the first guide wire. Just now, you are observing the intimal space and second guide wire from the subintimal space. This is the illustration of the IVAS image. Intima, target is located here, and the second guide wire is located here. So, which rotational direction of the wire? Token. The answer is undecided. Because, if the guide wire tip is directed in the right direction like this, you should pull back the second guide wire a little bit to pass through the intimal space and rotate clockwise to get the target. But if the guide wire tip is directed in the left direction like this, you should pull back the second guide wire a little bit also and rotate counterclockwise to get the target. So you should observe the guide wire tip to perform the 3D wiring in the CTO region. First, I'll explain the image delayed IVAS guided wiring, fusion of two images. This is a way to receive the information of the shaft and target intima from IVAS image and the direction of the tip from the angiographic image. And then you have to fuse these two images in your brain to construct a 3D image like this. So I'll deeply explain about this method. On IVAS image, you are seeing angio from here. So the shaft is located in front of the intima target and the tip is directed in the left direction like this. So you will fuse these two images. So you will a little bit pull back the guide wire and rotate it in the clockwise rotation to get the target. But in this IVAS image, you are also seeing angiographic image from here, like this. The shaft is located behind the target, and the tip is directed in the left direction, like this. So you will fuse these two images, so you can understand you have to a little bit pull back the guide wire and rotate it in the counterclockwise rotation to get the target, like this. This is the procedure result of 16 consecutive cases of CTO PCI of IVAS guided wiring when we developed a short tip IVAS for CTO intervention in Japan in 2012. The success rate of all procedures was over 90%, but the success rate of this IVAS guided wiring was 63%, which wasn't very high. At that time, I was practicing the fusion method. But even after that, the frequency of using the IVAS guided wiring didn't increase so much, and it was sometimes useful as a final option, but I feel the limitations of this method. To overcome these limitations, we have developed the Schottky pullback IBUS and device a tip detection method for real-time IBUS guided wiring. I'll explain the tip detection method. First, you have to advance the Schottky pullback IBUS through the first guide wire that has entered into the subintimal space. Then you have to use the pullback transducer system to observe the shaft and tip of the second guide wire. As you see, you can easily understand that which direction you should rotate the guide wire to get the target. In this situation, it is counterclockwise. Recently, I'm often asked if the tip is really visible. My answer is, you can see the tip if you are looking for it. The shaft is a bright point with an echo shadow, but the tip has an inflection point from the shaft like this, and it is visible as a slightly thinner line. This is a short tip pullback IBUS developed for the IBUS-based 3D wiring in CTO-PCI. This IBUS has both a short tip and a pullback transducer system. Specifically, the tip to the transducer length is 8mm. The transducer can be pulled back 15cm. To keep a good deliverability in the CTO regions, this IBUS has a long proximal monoid lumen, 26cm in length. In this way, you can easily advance this IBUS in the CTO region, and using the pullback transducer system, you can observe the second guide wire in the CTO region wherever, whenever you want. Before today's live demonstration, I will show the previous procedure of the IBUS-based 3D wiring using a tip detection method in the experimental CTO model. The first operator was Dr. Yoshikawa from Sanda City Hospital, and I was the second operator. A mock CTO region is made of 5% agar, whose diameter is 3.0 mm, and the length is 20 mm long, and a target tube with an inner diameter of 0.6 mm is inserted at the distal part of the mock CTO region, and it is inserted into the mid part of the RCA of the beating heart model, same as the angle-based 3D wiring. So this is floor image. The Schottky pullback IBUS was advanced beyond the target. Then we performed the tip detection method to accurately advance the second guide wire into the target. But mainly, we observed IBUS image. So this is 0.6 mm target, and the second guide wire was out of the target. So we planned that we pulled back this second guide wire 1 cm before, then we rotated this second guide wire counterclockwise to get the target, like this. So 1 cm pulled back, then we were rotating counterclockwise. This is shaft and tip, then this is shaft and tip. Counterclockwise, shaft and tip, more counterclockwise, shaft and tip. Then we accurately advanced the guide wire tip to the target and push it. We penetrated it. So as you see, it is no need of CNN to construct 3D image using a tip detection method. I will explain the procedural details of the IBUS-based 3D wiring using a tip detection method. First, I will explain how to prepare for the IBUS-based 3D wiring after a failure of AWE. You should advance the first guide wire to penetrate the target, but unfortunately, if the first guide wire was out of the target, you should advance the microcatheter to create a space for the IBUS. Then you should advance the second guide wire, if possible using the double chamber catheter. Then you should advance the microcatheter through the second guide wire. Then you should advance the IBUS through the first guide wire, like this. Next, I'll explain how to transfer 3D information from the IVAS image to angiographic image. Using the PROVAC system, the IVAS image shows the positional information of the second guide wire and intimal and subintimal spaces and exit lumen. However, the operators cannot recognize where intimal space and exit lumen are on the angiographic image. I'll explain how to get this information from the IVAS image to angiographic image. The second guide wire is advanced 1 cm before the target. Then the second guide wire is rotated for the tip to be facing to the operator. In this situation, it is clockwise rotation. Then tip detection method is performed. So you can easily understand that you are observing the scene from this direction. This is shaft and this is tip. So you are seeing scene from this direction on the IVAS image. So it is easy to understand that intima and exit to lumen are located on the right side on the angiographic image like this. Then I'll explain how to imagine preferred optimal route and perform the IVAS-based 3D wiring using a tip detection method. Using PROVAC system on the IVAS images, operators can imagine the optimal route for the second guide wire to reach a target like this. However, when there are obstacles before the exit, the operator should select the another route to reach the target to avoid these obstacles. Then, the first operator should manipulate the guide wire with an accuracy of 10 degrees by fluoroscopy in accordance with the instruction of the second operator performing the tip detection method like this. So, synchronization of first and second operators is very important. Finally, I'll explain the tips of IVAS-based 3D wiring using a tip detection method. First of all, the distance from where you should start a tip detection method is not specific, but I think it is better to start from about 1 cm before the final target from this point. When the guide wire is located more than 1 cm away from the final target, the fusion method is mainly used to avoid tangling the second guide wire with the IVAS catheter. And the tip detection method can be also used if necessary. When the guide wire is located less than 1 cm before the final target, the tip detection method should be performed as much as possible to accurately trace the preferred route and penetrate the exit route accurately. Next, I'll explain the selection of guiding catheter, microcatheter, and second guide wire and its shape. I recommend the 8-flange guiding catheter considering the backup force, but the 7-flange guide is also okay. The microcatheters used for the first guide wire can be used in this situation. The recommended second guide wire is a CTO of stiff wires whose tip load is more than or equal 9 grams. The tip shape of the second guide wire should be a 1 mm curve at an angle of 45 degrees like this, and the second curve is formed if necessary.